Sports presents the College Football National Championship. The Miami Hurricanes meet the Penn State Nittany Lions in the Sunkissed Fiesta Bowl. The ultimate game of this college football season will be played on a gorgeous night in the Valley of the Sun. As game time approaches, it's 60 degrees at Sun Devil Stadium in Tempe, Arizona. And we're just moments away from a meeting between two 11-0 teams ranked first and second in the country. An even dozen victories will make one of them the national champion. Good evening and a belated Happy New Year, everybody. I'm Bob Costas. We welcome you to a special game played under special circumstances. The four annual games, usually thought of as the major bowls, were unable to create a championship matchup this year. The Rose, Orange, Cotton, and Sugar all have commitments to various conference champions. They couldn't bring this pair of football independents together. But the Sunkissed Fiesta Bowl, anxious to increase its own prestige, could. So they sweetened the pot for Penn State and Miami. NBC moved the game from New Year's Day to primetime the next night, and a unique college football showcase has been created. And there is Paterno's coaching opponent, Jimmy Johnson, leading the 97 Hurricanes in uniform tonight out onto the field. Let's listen.
To the 20. An excellent return man just past the 30-yard line. And the Penn State Nittany Lions, led by their quarterback John Shaffer, an academic All-America, with deep play action. Almost sacked and then dumped. Dan Cilio. And Dan stopped. Offered in motion. With pressure again, and he is wrestled down for the second time in the ball game. This time it was Bill Hawkins who got it.
At 5-11.
And Testaverde's first pass is on target to Michael Irvin, and Irvin has the first down. As he goes out of bounds at the Penn State 47-yard line, he picks up 12 on the play. Testaverde over the middle to the tight end, Charles Henry, and Henry down at the 35-yard line, a gain of just over 10 yards and enough for the first down. Eddie Johnson. Fourth and four. 9:39 is the time, first quarter. Testaverde over the middle. Tipped. It's incomplete. Henry, the intended receiver, the tight end. The net. It's Fiesta Bowl. Testaverde to throw from the end zone, far side. And it is incomplete. Good defensive play by Duffy Cobb. Michael Irvin, Mr. Playmaker for the Canes. The completion, a fumble, and a recovery by Penn State. Duffy Cobb's got it. Down at 8, no score in the ball game. Opening moments of the second quarter. Testaverde, all the time in the world, and goes deep to Bratton. It's intercepted. Duffy Cobb to the 25, and returns to the 30-yard line. 15 yards on the return, and Duffy Cobb's his fifth interception. He had four during the season. And he has both turnovers for the Nittany Lions. He has the fumble recovery and the interception.
And what?
Hamilton, second and 11. Here comes pressure. Shaffer to throw. And he is hit. They're going to rule it a fumble, and Miami has recovered. Bill Hawkins. And it's first down goal to go. Testaverde to throw. And it is there. 1 yard line. Bratton over the top. He is met, but the ball just breaks the plane. That's all that it has to do. It is a touchdown. Scoring from a yard out.
The line of scrimmage, but it's tough to do it when somebody goes over the top, and Bratton gets the first score of the night. Miami 7-0 over Penn State.
It has not worked for him tonight.
And he has to throw here. It's third down and 12, deep over the middle. It is there. It is caught. Eric Hamilton pulls it in. A big first down, converting on third and 12. Tim Manoa, the first back throw. And Manoa rambles to the 20-yard line. He has 20. Back-to-back plays of more than 40 yards. Miami leads 7-0. Here's Shaffer rolling and throwing. The pass is complete. Manoa has it, and he is out of bounds at the 5-yard line. They get it off with a second to go. Shaffer rolling, wants to throw. It's open to run, and he dives for it, and he's got it. Reaction of John Shaffer as he moves the Nittany Lions in 12 plays for the tie. We'll be back with a kickoff. Halftime activities will continue in a moment, and that means that we'll be right back after these messages from your local station.
Switch now to the White House in Washington, D.C., and Mr. President, as a former sportscaster yourself, I wonder if you'd critique the work of Charlie Jones and the NBC crew tonight.
Well, I think it's been just great, and I've been enjoying every minute of this. I, of course, have to tell you that having done all of my broadcasting on radio, I don't envy those of you who have to talk on television, because I liked it better when the audience had to wait to find out from you what was going on. I think it's awfully easy to get carried away and sort of make players feel that they're not really students of the college. They're sort of hired hands to be there and play. I hope that isn't widespread, and I don't think it should be. I think that the old college try and the college spirit is really the thing that makes college football great. And I think that the students are there, or the players are there as students, and they should be there with that in mind.
Well, it was quite a battle. That's what we were expecting. We knew it was going to be a 60-minute ball game. A couple of penalties really hurt us there in the first half. I felt like if we hadn't had the penalties, we could have put some points on the board, because, you know, Penn State didn't really stop us. We turned it over a couple of times, and then we had penalties that stopped us.
And you can see exactly what Bob Griesen was talking about with the set of the eight players. In the gaps, it is up, it is in the air, it is intercepted, it is Selwyn Brown. And Brown to the 40-yard line of Penn State. 18 yards on the interception return by 16 of 30, 184 yards. As time slips a bit, throws, it's intercepted by Conlan. Conlan stumbles and falls.
He's only count the ball up 10 times on fumble.
Here's a fumble. And Miami has the ball. No play action fake. And Testaverde is brought down by Pete Giftopoulos.
The snapper,
and it is no good. It is off to the right. The 46, Testaverde to throw. It is intercepted by Giftopoulos to the 45, to the 40, and down at the 36-yard line. That's way short. Just concerned they'll go to the rushing attack and then they get away from it. Maybe they will stay with it here. As Heisman slips, he may break clean. He's to the 30 and goes to the 27-yard line. And it is good from 38 yards away. And Miami leads for the second time in the ballgame. The score, the Canes 10, the Nittany Lions 7. Will be back with a kickoff. Second down. Testaverde with both backs into block, throws, and it is intercepted. Conlan to the five. Dozier. Dozier scores. Official. The Penn State Nittany Lions are the national champions. John Shaffer's record as a starting quarterback since the seventh grade is now 66-1.
This is the way you win a national championship, out on the field.
Hope you would that way. I think our kids played a great game. They beat a great football team tonight. I think our defense played about as great a college football game as I've ever seen.
You've won a lot of big games, but this is the biggest one.
Well, it's one of the biggest ones, certainly. We've had a lot of luck in our life, and I've been fortunate to be around a lot of great young people and great coaches. And I just thank the good Lord for everything he's given me.
All right, congratulations, Coach. You guys are number one.
Well, I think so.
All right, back up to Bob Gustin.
This is the 100th season of Penn State football, and they celebrate that century of excellence with a national title tonight. Vinny,
this is the time.
Bitter taste of this defeat fades away for Jimmy Johnson and for Vinny Testaverde. We hope they too will have fond memories of the experience of this college football season, a season which ends without a national title for them and with the national championship for Joe Paterno and the Nittany Lions of Penn State. We'll see